What's up, guys? If you don't have a couple of hours to watch a really long video on how to make a WordPress website for your small business, check this out. In 15 minutes, I'm going to show you how to create this amazing website you're looking at right here, and absolutely for free. You're not going to have to spend a single cent in the next 15 minutes. So while you're having your lunch, while you're having your coffee, check out this video, follow along, and start creating this. You'll be able to have it up and running like this, exactly like I have actually, in the next 15 minutes. And if that does happen and I keep my promise, please hit the thumbs up button, share it with your friends, and ask any questions in the comments below. Here we go. Okay, so as we start to make our small business website, it'll be helpful if you go to www.emediacoach.com/1515. And what I'm going to make sure is that that redirects to this page over here. It is a page on my website that will be the one page help guide to this tutorial, and you'll see the 5 steps listed here. I'll embed this video after I finish making this tutorial, and I'll add some useful links and frequently asked questions. So the first thing is to go to step 1, install WordPress, and click on the link over here. Bitnami will allow you to install WordPress on your own computer without purchasing web hosting or anything like that, and it'll be absolutely free, so you can start practicing to set up and create your own business website. So I've got a Windows computer, so I'm going to download the Windows WordPress installer, but if you've got a Mac, just select the relevant one and just take me to the download. It's going to ask you to save that download file. Just wait till that finishes. After you've downloaded that, just open up that installer and follow the steps to install the WordPress stack onto your own computer. So it'll take about 3 or 4 minutes, and just follow that process through until that's done. Leave all of that as default. Enter a name, your email address, a login username, and you'll use this to log into WordPress, as well as your new password. And then click Next. You can give your website a name, or you can change that later. And leave everything else as default, follow through, and install that package. And you'll see that installation progress on your computer. It'll take 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, brilliant. And now let's launch the Bitnami WordPress stack. You should see this page here, and if you click on Access WordPress, you've successfully installed WordPress onto your own computer. So I'll just minimize that. Here are some important pieces of information you should write down. So I'll copy that and just note that down. You should note this down as well. That there is your WordPress URL on your local computer. In the future, if you follow the final step, that will be replaced with whatever your business name.com is. But for now, that's our practice URL. Then that /login will be your login page if you need to log into your WordPress dashboard, if you've logged yourself out, and you'll be able to use the username and password that you entered during the installation process. And there we go, that's the dashboard of your WordPress website. This is the engine behind your entire website and what you'll be using to configure and create your website, and it's going to be super easy. So that's step 1 done. You've successfully installed WordPress. Simple as that, it was free and painless. Okay, so now on to the second step, install the web design, and that's also going to be free. So now that we've logged into our WordPress dashboard using that URL there, and the username and password, you should be in that screen here. So now, to install the website design, you need to go to Appearance and then go to Themes. In WordPress, a design is known as a theme. We're going to add a new theme, so click on that button and search in this box for a theme called Astra, A-S-T-R-A, and click Enter. And that is the one, so click on the Install button. And now click on Activate. The next thing we need to do is go into Plugins and click on Add New. and we need to install a plugin called Astra Starter Sites. So search for that. And what this will allow you to do is to deploy, in other words, install some ready-made website design, and they look spectacular, and you'll just have to go in and tweak images, pictures, stuff like that. So a plugin is just simply something that extends the functionality of WordPress, and so that's what we're doing here. We're using the Astra Starter Sites plugin. Click on Install Now. And when that's installed, click on Activate. Once that's activated, you should see this screen here. If you don't, just hover over Appearance in a sidebar and go to Astra Sites. And then the next thing I need you to do is click on Elementor. And just like it says, these are starter sites. You can click on any one of these and preview any one of these with the click of a button. Install this as your new website design. It's freaking amazing. Anything that has an agency next to this, next to the design like this, means that it's a paid design, but everything else is free. So as you saw, that one looked amazing. It's free. This one's pretty good as well. And again, one click deployment if you want to use this design along with all the other pages. But the one I'm going to use for this demonstration is this one here. There's no real reason behind it. It's just what I choose to use for this demonstration. You can use any of the designs that you like in the previous screen. So once you've chosen the right one that you want to base your website design off, just click on Install Plugins. It will install all of these essential plugins. And don't worry if you're not sure. You can always go back to the previous step and choose a brand new website design and then implement that one, and it will replace everything with the new design. So there we go. That's been activated. And now we just need to click on this Import This Website button. Yes, we want it to overwrite everything and install this brand new website design. And this will take about a minute, so just give it a little bit of time. There we go, the import is complete, and let's view our website. So there you are, go to your website URL, and that's what your business website currently looks like. It's amazing, and you can now start editing content, and that's what I'll show you next. Don't worry about this black bar over here. That only shows because we're logged into WordPress. Your visitors will never see that. Now the third step is to customize text, images, buttons, and anything else you want to customize on your website with your own content. So what you do is you can either go to the page you want to edit and click on Edit with Elementor, or you can go into the WordPress dashboard and hover over Pages, go to All Pages, find the page you want to edit, in this case the home page, and then click Edit with Elementor. And you'll be able to customize basically anything and everything you want on your web page. Let's take this image for example. Let's click on this button here. Let's go to Style. I'm going to delete that image by clicking there. I'm going to add a new image and select one from my computer. That's uploading. Insert media. And then I'm going to align this one. Position, center, center. There we go. And just a little tip. I like to use Unsplash for my photos. You can basically type in anything you want, and they've got a huge bank of really cool photos you can use on your website, and they're all royalty free. That's where I got this one from. So we've updated an image. You can update your text simply by clicking there and making any updates. So simple. I can even edit buttons. So if I click on that over there, anytime you click on something, you'll see some options in the side area over here. I can update the link. I know in the future I'm going to have a page called Services. You can always come back here and change that at any time. You can change alignments, the size of the button, styling, all that kind of stuff. Now let's take this for example. If I click there on this icon, I can actually click on that and choose a completely different icon if I want to. Or I can get rid of that altogether. So let's do that. Of course you can click here, update the text, like I showed you before, very, very easy. Now, say I don't want this module over here, for example. Let's click on that. Let's click on this cross icon. It'll delete that entire section. What that deleted was that component. But if I want to delete this entire section, I'm just going to click on that section and hit the delete section area cross button over here. So that's a very easy, simple rundown on how to make changes. And you can make changes to any part of your website on any page simply by clicking, looking at what's available in the sidebar, and making the appropriate changes. So anytime you make an update, make sure you click on the update button over here. Then if you go to your website, so if I click on those over here and click on view page, you'll see those changes have been reflected on the front end. And just in case I didn't make it clear, these pages have also been automatically deployed, and you can use any one of these pages, and to edit them, it's the same process. Click on Edit with Elementor. That will take you into the Edit dashboard. And you can click on any section that you want to change, just like that, and you'll be able to make those changes in this side area over here. You can change images, text, headings, icons, buttons, and anything else you want. You can add modules, remove modules. But that takes me on to the next section. The next step to making our small business website is to add new pages. So if I go back in here, click on these three lines, I can exit to the WordPress dashboard. Now what I can do is click on Pages and Add New Pages. And I can give this new page any title I want. For example, let's call it some sort of a service that you may have. I can click on Edit with Elementor. And now here's the cool part. I am going to add a template. So see this icon over here? Click on that. I'm going to add a fully functional brand new page with the click of a button. So let's scroll down. Let's have a look at this page. Okay, I like the look of that page. I can simply click Insert. And there we go. That entire page and design has been inserted. And I can click Publish. And that now exists on my website. There we go. Let me give you another example. If I go back and add a page, edit with Elementor, click on that templates icon. You can click on the magnifying glass to preview any particular page. That one looks pretty good. And I can even go up and search for a contact page, for example. And so let's have a look at a nice free contact page. This is probably one here. I think that's pretty cool. It's got a map as well. You can put your business location. So, okay, I'm going to click Insert. And there we go. We've created a contact page. I can also add individual modules. So if I go to blocks instead of pages, I can add individual blocks or components to a particular page. And I can choose from any one of these. And then once I add it, I can then style it in any way I want, with different colors, fonts, text, images, just like you would for any other section. So there we go, simple as that to add new pages to your website. So we've, with the click of a button, added a service page, and we've added a contact us page. Okay, so that brings us to step 5, adapt the menu over here, and perhaps even add a drop-down menu so that customers can find information very, very easily. So to do that, go back into your WordPress dashboard, hover over Appearance, and go to Menus. This interface you're looking at here is very, very user-friendly. You can do one of a few things. If you've already created a page, you can click on the checkbox and click Add to Menu, and that will add that to the menu structure. You can also add some custom links. So for the purposes of a demo, I'm just going to copy that homepage URL and call it Home. Add to menu. You can also delete things. And so as you can see, you can really customize your menu and its structure. And like I've just done there, drag and drop an item based on where you want it to appear in the sequence. Now, if I just add one more page, let's say this one, for example, and click Save Menu. Make sure also that the primary menu is enabled. I'm going to refresh the site. You'll see that that now appears. However, I want my services to appear under services. So you may have various sections to your website. You'll want to manage your hierarchy of your website so customers can find what they're looking for. So in this case, we want these things to appear as a submenu. So when someone hovers over this, it appears as a submenu under it. That's very simple. All you need to do is drag and drop that under the item you want it to appear and then indent it like so, and that will be a sub item. Let's get that one as well. You can also rearrange the order in which sub items appear. You can also rename the labels. So let's say services 1. And I think you get the idea. So if we click on Save Menu and then refresh the website, you'll see that that has taken effect. There's now a drop-down arrow. When someone hovers over that, they can now easily navigate through the various parts of your brand new website. So that brings us to the end. And the final step is to launch it live, because you probably don't want a URL like this. You want to launch it live to the public so that your URL looks something like this. And you can use it for all of your marketing material. It'll be live to the public and you can start attracting more business. So I hope we've been able to help you create an amazing WordPress website in just 15 minutes. And please, I urge you to help us by hitting the thumbs up button, sharing with your friends, and also subscribing, because I want to put out some more amazing content in the future that helps you progress your business and make it as successful as it can possibly be. But if you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask me either in the comments or contact me via the contact form on my website. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.